Hi, and welcome to this TI Precision Lab on Ethernet PHYs. In this session, we'll spend a few minutes looking at a schematic design guide for 100BASE-TX Ethernet Physical Layer Transceivers, or Ethernet PHYs for short. In this video, we'll cover the major areas of focus when designing a system for 100BASE-TX PHYs. If you haven't watched What is an Ethernet PHY TI Precision Labs, please make sure to review that video first so you have a high-level overview on what an Ethernet PHY is. This is a standard block diagram for a typical 100BASE-TX application. It's important to understand what blocks the PHY requires as it will help with the design and review of the schematic. On the left side of the diagram, 100BASE-TX PHY is connected to the Media Access Control, or MAC, in the digital domain, while on the MDI, or Media Dependent Interface, side, the signals are routed through magnetic isolation to an RJ45 connector. You'll notice that the MAC and MDI have integrated termination resistors in the PHY. Check the datasheet of your 100BASE-TX PHY and confirm if the PHY does or does not contain the integrated resistors. The PHY will need a supply for the core and I/O voltages and will also need a reference clock input. The design can also use hardware bootstraps through resistors to configure certain operating modes on the PHY. This EVM board is a typical layout using a 100BASE-TX Ethernet PHY. Some of the major areas of focus when designing a 100BASE-TX PHY application are the power supplies, straps and LEDs, clock, the PHY, the MAC interface, and the magnetics. This design supports external DC power supplies or through the USB interface. This design also uses an onboard MSP430 or external pins to access the registers of the PHY. Some other items to consider when designing your application are the types of connectors or testing points you plan to place on your board. This design uses an RJ45 connector on the MDI or Media Dependent Interface side for connection to the analog domain. Most Ethernet applications use an RJ45 connector and cable. RJ45 is the type of connector commonly used for Ethernet networking. On the digital domain, or the MAC interface side, an adapter board is plugged in for ease of testing. Let's take a look at the PHY portion and its accompanying components in a schematic. We'll use a TI-10100BASE-TX PHY as an example for this schematic review. The pinout should be very similar to other 100BASE-TX PHYs across TI's portfolio. First, you'll need to verify the correct voltage rails are connected to the core and I/O pins. You'll also need to ensure that the decoupling capacitors on the supply match the datasheet requirements. Typical footprint sizes used for the decoupling capacitors are 0402s or 0201s. In the future, when beginning the layout, you'll need to ensure the capacitors are placed very close to the PHY. Next, you'll need to ensure you have differentially coupled signals on the MDI pins. In layout, you'll need to consider the 100 ohm impedance matching for these differential traces. Finally, you'll need the correct resistor values on MDIO and R-bias. Please refer to the datasheet on the recommended values and tolerances. R-bias values for PHYs should be 1% tolerance. When selecting your PHY's clock source, it's important to consider its frequency tolerance, stability, and load capacitance. Frequency tolerance is the initial accuracy of the crystal frequency in parts per million. Frequency stability is the drift of the crystal frequency over temperature. It's usually specified over the full operating range of the crystal. Be sure to select a crystal with an operating temperature range that matches your application. Load capacitance is specified by the crystal vendor, and the ESR is the effective series resistance of the crystal. The load capacitor values vary with the crystal vendors, so be sure to check with the vendor for the recommended loads. R1 is current limiting resistor that may be required if the maximum dry level of the crystal is less than 500 microwatts. 100BASE-TX PHYs support either an external CMOS level oscillator source or a crystal resonator device. The X1 pin is a clock input requiring either 25 or 50 MHz depending on the MAC interface used. In MII mode or RMII master mode, either 25 MHz crystal or 25 MHz oscillator may be used. When an RMII slave, a 50 MHz clock is used. For more information on clock selections for your Ethernet PHYs, don't forget to watch How to Configure Ethernet Reference Clocks after this video. On the MDI side, magnetics should be selected as per the specifications listed in the datasheet. The RJ45 specs to consider include the turn ratio, isolation, and return loss. The dashed box shown here is highlighting the common mode choke and magnetics of the PHY. Common mode chokes should be kept facing the cable side. On the PHY side of the magnetics, the center tap should be connected to the ground via decoupling capacitors. Other types of connectors may be used, such as ones with integrated magnetics. Capacitive coupling may also be used as well. Pull-ups are not required on the center tap since 100BASE-TX PHYs use voltage mode line drivers. If you are using a current mode line driver PHY, please verify that the pull-up resistors are added to the center taps. On the cable side of magnetics, the center tap should have Bobsmith termination. Bobsmith termination is used to reduce noise resulting from common mode current flows, as well as reduce susceptibility to any noise from unused wired pairs on the RJ45. The capacitors used here should be high voltage rated. Earth ground and system ground should be separate from each other with precision to connect them with 1 mega ohm resistors and 4700 picofarad capacitors. When reviewing your Mac interface design, it's important to consider which interface you're using for your application. MII, or Media Independent Interface, is a synchronous 4-bit wide nibble data interface that connects the PHY to the Mac. RMII, or Reduced Media Independent Interface, provides a reduced pin count alternative interface. Typically, Mac interface, in this case RMII or MII, signals are directly routed between Mac and PHY. In certain cases, it's acceptable to route the signals via connector. Some of TI's 100BASE-TX PHYs have integrated MAC interface resistors for impedance matching, so external resistors are not required. External resistors can be optionally added to reduce energy on the RMII signal to improve emissions performance. Texas Instruments 100BASE-TX PHYs have many of the functional pins as strap options to place the device into specific modes of operation. The values of these pins are sampled at power-up or hard reset. During software reset, the strap options are internally reloaded from the values sampled at power-up or hard reset. The strap option pin assignments are defined below. Configuration of the device may be done through the strap pins or through management register interface. A pull-up resistor or a pull-down resistor of suggested values may be used to set the voltage ratio of the strap pin input and the supply to select one of the possible selected modes. Strap pins have 2 levels or more depending on which PHY you are using. Please refer to a 100BASE-TX datasheet to understand if there are 2 or more levels on your PHY. During power-up, the PHY has a default configuration when no bootstrap resistors are used. If it's desired to change certain features from the default mode, then external pull-up resistors can be used. It's also important to note that LEDs can be configured as strap pins, and the polarity of the LED output will depend on the strap resistor. Thank you for viewing this Precision Lab session on 100BASE-TX Ethernet PHY schematic designs. To find more Ethernet technical resources and to search TI's portfolio of Ethernet PHY products, visit ti.com/ethernet.